Try and get yourself a couple of rulers, rather like this, with a groove down the middle where the pencil goes to stop it falling off the disc. And if you can get two and put them end to end with their fire ends raised up on matchboxes or something like that, with the groove continuous, you'll be able to have a lot of fun and interest with some marbles. Get them the same size. I'm going to use about four here of smaller marbles that'll fit in that groove. And see what happens if I roll another one down from this end. Surprisingly, it doesn't move the whole chain. You just get this reaction. One marble moves one from the other end. And back it comes. Let's try it again. Here it goes. One marble moves one. It's the sort of effect you get if you do trick snooker shots. That's if the balls are all in a line. The white one hits the end of the red chain and one red one comes off at the end. Notice they've got to be in a line or else they start moving apart. One moves one. And it's not restricted to one. For example, if I pull two back here and let them go, those two will move two off the other end. And if I put an extra one in and do three, those three will move three, and so on. But that's very clumsy. It falls apart and you have marbles all over the floor if you're not careful. So an easier way of studying that is to make yourself some momentum marbles, and here they are. They hang in a line, they can't go anywhere, and there's less friction, so they keep going longer. And if I take one there, let it go, we get this. One, 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 one. Notice how much longer it keeps going. And we can investigate what happens if we take two back. Two here gives us two there. And three will give us three. Not only that, we can get mixed rhythms. One at one end, two at the other, and they change places. And we can do all sorts of fascinating things like that. Well, how do you make it? Very simply, but there are a couple of things to observe. First of all, get some bigger marbles if you can. They're heavier and they'll work a bit better. Marbles of about that sort of size. And you need to make some hooks on them for the thread, and that's done by getting some very flexible wire, and a pair of fine-nosed pliers are best if you can get them. Just bend yourself little hooks, which come out to be a sort of V with loops on either leg. And those loops give you a bigger area to stick onto the marble. Well, it's not always easy to get glass glues, or glues that stick to glass, but in fact, if you can get this sort of epoxy resin, where you add one part to another and it sets very fast, you're doing well. Because that will give you a bond of this kind. You can see that's stuck on there, and it's really very firm indeed. You can't pull that off, it won't drop off, as some glues will. The next step is to get the thread and thread it through the loop. And if you do that, leave yourself quite a bit of spare thread so that you can adjust the knot when you tie it onto your stick. Well, tying it onto the stick means you've got to mark the stick first. So get a ruler, measure the thickness of the marbles, and make marks at exactly that thickness all the way along the top of the ruler, or the top of the stick, I should say. That means that when you put the threads on there, the marbles will hang with their sides exactly touching each other, and that's the best position for them to be in. Right, you make the marks along there, put lines straight across there, make sure they really are square. And where those lines cut the edge of the stick, get a sharp knife and make little notches. And that means that the thread can hang through there and it won't move around. Once you set the stick up like that, you can make any number, but it is harder to get them to hang in a line if there are lots of them. You then get the marble with the thread, get the twist out of it, and tie it round through those notches. Now this is a little difficult. It's very hard to tie a knot so that the thread is exactly the right length. So get it as close as you can and leave it just a little bit too long. The merest amount and tie it off. Because it's much easier to shorten the whole thing than it is to lengthen it once you've tied your knot. That's a little bit too long. We can cut off the spare and jack the whole thing up with little chips of cardboard or matchstick or wood or anything. But by lifting that thread and poking things under there, we'll slowly lift the marble into the air until it's hanging in the right line. And once you've done it like that, put dobs of glue on there and you'll find the whole thing is held in the right position. Well, I'll get rid of him because I couldn't do him accurately. And that's the sort of result you get. Six or seven marbles is ample, and you can investigate all those fascinating rhythms you can get with momentum marbles.